Hello guys, this is Chris again. Today I want to quickly share my tips about job interviews. All of those interviews that I've been attending, I was telling you about it in my other video, about 20 personal interviews that I've been attending while looking for my first data analyst job in Poland. And not because, you know, it was mostly because I was having fun and could keep going on the interviews after I already got a job offer. I also think that kind of couple of first interviews were quite weird, like, why are you even here? Who are all those people? I don't even know if I want to work with you guys. But then I actually liked the process. I kept going there, and maybe like last 5-7 of them were just for fun. But anyway, it was quite an experience. For those of you who never looked for their job all by themselves without like friends help or family help, that information would be quite useful. For those of you who don't know who I am Chris, and I live abroad for around 8 years. Right now I am in Germany, but I have been living in also Poland and Belarus, and I would like to share my experience about job, like changing careers, motivation, self-education, so make sure you subscribe. So job search is actually somewhat like dating. Why? Because the main similarity is that you have to kind of focus on your feelings after you got out of there. And when you're going home after the interview, you have to ask yourself, you have to kind of feel what you kind of experience at the moment, which feelings do you have. Something like, do you want to come back there right now? Do you want to go back there and start working immediately, like tomorrow? Or do you feel kind of awkward? Did you not like one of those people there? Do you maybe feel like you never want to meet them again and never want to touch their test exercise or like test work, the piece of work that they gave you? So this is, if you feel something negative, this is a very good chance you will not enjoy working there. You will spend 40 hours a week with those people in this office, so make sure you ask questions during the interview. This interview is not only for them, it is also for you. So what you have to ask is something that is really important for you. For example, if you really want to bike to work, you have to ask about biking, like parking for bikers, or you have to ask about, you know, some extras if you're interested in them, about like coffee machines in the office, about lunch places, or is it actually something available around the office to go to lunch quickly and come back, you know, because you don't want to end up in a place where, you know, the only one food you can actually get is some lousy canteen that you will hate. You have to have some things on your mind to ask about upfront, because it's easier this way for both of you, for employer and for you. Make sure you look on your employer really, really carefully during the interview and see things behind those looks. Like, for example, there was one employer in Poland who was offering actually a very shitty amount of money for this work that I wanted to apply for, but I went anyway. And that was hilarious because he came in this like little office where the interview was taking place. He came with this little like Mac with Air or something, or Pro, I don't remember. And this computer was making this funny like cracking sounds, like, and it was making like this all the interview long. And I was thinking to myself, well, maybe the things in this company are not that good. Listen to the questions they are asking you, and you will hear whether they are actually interested in you already as a person, like for soft skills, or as a professional. It doesn't really matter. If they will hire you for soft skills, that's actually not such a terrible thing. I've been hired for soft skills once, and I also was hired once for the fact that I've been in Iceland and that I am fan of astronomy. That was just funny, and that was one of the coolest jobs I've ever had. On the other hand, if they're asking some generic stuff like, oh, where do you see yourself in 5 years? Well, okay, this question is actually good, but anyway, if the questions are empty and generic, that means that they didn't put any thought into what are they gonna talk with you about, and it may even mean that they are not even treating you as one of the potential candidates. read behind the lines. This is my favorite. If they are saying something like, oh, organization of our company or like structure of our company is really complicated, that means it is a chaos there. If they're saying something like, oh, we have so much work right now to do, like so much work, that means you will really, really, really work like 10, 14 hours a day. And if they're saying something like, oh, we are a team of three and one person is leaving in 3 months, that means that they are taking you as a replacement. That is, I am a captain obvious here, I know, but maybe it's not clear. This thing is also something I really love doing. For example, if I see that this person is actually a former employee of this company that I'm interested in, I mean, you can find this information in open sources in the internet, like, you know, in different countries, their websites are different. I will mention them some other time. But right now, like Golden Line, LinkedIn, Xing.com in Germany. So there, if you see a person whom you can actually ask about how was it, you just write them a personal message, that's it. And that is how I avoided one of the interviews. And actually one time I also asked around about one company and I said no to their job offer just because the person who've been working there said that this like company is complete mess. So I just skipped it, you know. That was really cool thing to do. And the last thing, do not forget that this is, if they hired you actually, if they are about to hire you, that this is a probation period for both sides. Not only for them, but also for you. And if you see within this 3 months or whatever, whichever amount of months you have in your country, and if you see that you do not like it here, you do not enjoy spending time with those people in this building, just don't be afraid to give it up, because it is much easier to leave when you just started than leaving in like a couple of years when you already gave so much time and energy to this place which you never actually loved. Let me know in the comment section down below how long did it take you to find your first job without any help, and if you ever done it. And thank you very much and see you next time. Bye bye.